Hey, welcome back to Total Lab. Today we're going to test the Infinix Note 30 Pro, which we bought in Malaysia. The charging power of most Infinix phones can be roughly divided into 18, 33, 68, and 120 watts. And the phone we got can support 68 watts fast charging, theoretically. But what is the actual charging performance? Let's test it out. In addition to the Infinix Note 30 Pro, the package also contains a 68 watts original charger, original cable, case, screen protector, and manual. The input plug of the original charger is UK standard. The original USB-A port has a special pin, similar to the Xiaomi charger. This pin allows the USB-A port to support the PD protocol. Infinix and 68 watts are printed on the front. And the specs info are printed at the bottom. Model is U682XKA. It can support input of 120 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2 amp. Its charging power can be up to 21 volts, 3.25 amp, 68 watts. And the size is about 70 by 47 by 30 millimeter. So the power density is about 0.71 watts cubic centimeter. The weight is about 118 grams. Move to the original USB-A to USB-C cable. The length is about 1 meter. The USB-A of the cable also has a special pin, same as the original charger. Those two pins can work together to trigger the PD protocol. The charger that powers ZKM003C shows that the charger supports QC 3.0, PD 3.0, PBS, QC 4+, and DCP protocols. It also has 5 fixed PDLs of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts 3 amp, 20 volts 2.25 amp, and 2 sets of PBS. So it can support 45 watts PD fast charging through the original cable, and it has a full voltage of 5 to 20 volts. Now let's take a look at the phone itself. It adopts MediaTek Helio G99 and has a battery capacity of 5000 mAh. It supports 68 watts fast charging and 50 watts wireless charging. And it also supports 5 watts wired or wireless reverse charging. Here we got the 8 plus 256GB version. It adopts a 6.67 inches 120Hz OLED display. There is a power button that integrates fingerprint. The back panel adopts a flash finish. Next, let's see its charging compatibility. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows the power is about 9 volts, 6 amp, 56 watts when charging it with the original 68 watts charger and cable. Replace the original cable with a Xiaomi 6 amp cable, there's almost no change in input power. Next, switch to an ordinary cable. This cable does not have a special pin to support PD protocol or a widened pin to support a high current. But the power is about the same as the original one and the current even reaches 6 amp. We do not recommend using this cable because it may burn your device. It supports AI Smart Charge. This function can adjust the charging speed according to habits to protect the battery and extend the battery life. In addition, it supports bypass charging, which means the charger can directly power the phone without the battery. This function is suitable for playing games because it can reduce heating and extend the battery life. As for third-party chargers, most of them can charge it at 9 volts, but Apple 35 watts compact and McDonald 40 watts charger cannot charge it. Chargers without PBS protocol can only charge it about 15 watts. Those PD 3.0 or PBS chargers can reach more than 20 watts and up to 33 watts. The charging power of most power banks and power stations is around 20 watts, and the highest power does not exceed 30 watts. Next, we'll use the original 68 watts charger and cable to fully charge the Infinix Note 30 Pro. The voltage stays at 9 volts first, and the charging curve can be divided into 3 parts. In the first part, the peak power reaches 42.3 watts within seconds and begins to drop immediately. Then the power gradually drops to 33 watts at 25 minutes. The final part begins at 50 minutes and the voltage drops from 9 volts to 5 volts. At the same time, the power starts to drop to almost zero. It takes 58 minutes to be fully charged. As you can see in the other curve, the original 68 watts charger and cable can charge the Infinix Note 30 Pro to 50% in 17 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 29 minutes, 100% in 58 minutes. Since the overall power is much less than 68 watts, its charging speed is slower than that of phones with the same power. Next, we put the phone into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the temperature test, and recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 30 minutes. After 10 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.7 degrees Celsius, and the back is 36.9 degrees Celsius. High temperature areas are on the lower side of the camera module. After 20 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front slightly increases to 39 degrees Celsius and the back is 39.2 degrees Celsius. After 30 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 37.7 degrees Celsius, lower than the 20 minutes, and the back is 37.1 degrees Celsius. As the charging time increases, the temperature reaches highest at 20 minutes, you will feel warm when holding it. But the temperature at 30 minutes is lower than that at 20 minutes because of the decrease in charging power. That's all charging tests for the Infinix Note 30 Pro. It supports 45W PD and 68W proprietary protocols. However, after testing, the power is around 30 to 40W during most fast charging period. So its charging speed is slower than those phones with the same power, but it is faster than Apple and Samsung. Due to the low charging power, the highest temperature can be acceptable. At a such cheap price, this phone can give you a such passable charging performance and some useful charging functions. So, you may consider it. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!